You are at war. The most cruel, never-ending war in history without a winner. You are at war with yourself. There is you on the inside and another one on the outside. The one on the inside is long forgotten even by yourself while trying to hide it from everyone. But sometimes, when you lose control, when you forget or fail to oppress, that you, the real you, comes out, reaches out and reminds itself and says, I am here. You failed in destroying me. When you are most vulnerable. When you are asleep. We call these dreams, you know. We interpret them. We say, I'll get bad news. I saw a road, it means a journey, I will go somewhere. We think an unworldly power interferes in our sleep and informs us about the future. You know what this is? This is another weapon we have. One of the tools we use to oppress our true self. So, what do they mean? Are we trying to tell ourselves something? What do those images we see in our sleep mean? Why do we dream? A question with an equally simple and difficult answer, with or without an answer. But the questions we ask get us closer to the answer. So let us start asking, walk towards the answers together. The first question is, why do we dream? The topic of this video. With numerous books and researches made, films shot, William Demet says, dreaming permits each and every one of us to be quietly and safely insane every night of our lives. I love this answer, but I'm not satisfied. But you know, dreaming is not a natural law, so the answers will vary. For instance, the answers will be completely different depending on the person you ask, be it a spiritualist or a rationalist. Ernest Hartmann, a psychiatry professor, for example, says, the most honest answer is, that we do not yet know the function or functions of dreaming. But he has an idea. Thus, we consider a possible, though certainly not proven function of a dream, to be weaving new material into the memory system in a way that both reduces emotional arousal and is adaptive in helping us cope with further trauma or stressful events. This also makes sense. When you think about it, thoughts we never pay attention to or consciously ignore might be processed in our minds when our consciousness is out of control during sleep. Still, there is something missing here. I mean, not comprehensive enough. So let's change our perspective. Dr. Matthew Walker, the author of the book Why We Sleep, Unlocking the Power of Sleep and Dreams, has a similar definition. Dreaming appears to take the painful sting out of difficult, even traumatic, emotional episodes experienced during the day, offering emotional resolution when you awake the next morning. Still the same, many explanations seem parallel to each other. Dreams help clean our minds, and they even physically help remove toxic proteins, besides more organized and clear comprehension of all events. Let's take a moment here to talk about the Acura Tribe. Why? No worries. They tell us a lot of things about this dreaming issue. Acura people living in the rainforest stretching in the coast of Ecuador and Peru are people who have been continuing their traditional lifestyle for hundreds of years. These people were contacted in the 70s for the first time are not completely unplugged, but they have never given up on their traditions and especially some significant rituals. And they met the hideous face of the modern times in the 90s. The soils Ecuadors lived on were found to be rich in oil, and the Ecuador government releases a law allowing the drill for oil in their lands, leaving the destiny of these people at the hand of greedy corporations. Ecuadors had to make a decision against this disaster that had already started nearby and closing up every minute. They could have an agreement with the corporations and live in the houses given to them or protect their lands even if it meant death. And they did what they had been doing for centuries to make this decision. They slept. Yes, I guess you call this lucid dreaming. They did that. A traditional ritual used by Ecuadors in times of critical turning points, such as this one. What they did was that Ecuadors went to sleep in the evening as usual, and they all woke up a couple hours before dawn to smoke a herb called guayusa, that is a really strong stimulant. And they conducted a group ride, all together under the influence of the stimulant. Of course, everybody saw or heard different things. Images or voices we can call hallucinations. An inner guide for Acura people. When the influence of the herb faded away, everybody shared their experiences and they made a decision regarding the fate of the tribe using this inner guide. They mostly used this ritual individually or in small groups before, But this time they got together with all neighboring tribes that they were normally enemies with. Thousands of people woke up together that night, smoked guayusa, and different tribes shared their decisions via messengers. And the result is, they decided not to leave their lands and resist these corporations no matter what. In the end, they were victorious and got to keep their soils. Happy ending, I guess. So, back to our main topic. What does the story tell us? Many things, of course, but one of the things is, dreams can be more than random images. What we dream of when our conscious is not engaged can be our inner voice, maybe our true self. Before making this interference, we need to talk about two names that comes to mind when we say dreams: Sigmund Freud and Carl Jung. Especially Freud is obsessed about dreams, and he said dreams were realization of intentions in his book The Interpretation of Dreams, where he also talked about his well-known Oedipus complex. The emergence of things we want deep inside, especially when we are children, a time when the conscious is not so active. Realization of our wishes that even we, ourselves, are not aware that we want. The relaxation of the mind. But what about those illogical and irrational dreams? I mean, some dreams are so stupid. What do these mean? Well, Freud says that they are distractions of the conscious. Our true wishes turn into illogical images with the interference of the conscious. In his book, Freud also gives some examples. For example, he says, boys mostly dream about their father's death. This is where he talks about the Oedipus complex. He thinks, boys see their fathers as rivals, sharing the love of their mothers, and trying to take her away from him. This is why they subconsciously want them dead. We need to keep in mind, children do not view death as we do. It is something like the father goes away for a long time and does not come back. Let's not consider them as maniacs with murder potentials. But this is what Freud considers dreams as. We realize our wishes and our dreams. Anyways, Carl Jung, he has a completely different point of view on dreams. He believes dreams are windows to our true self, a path to the deepest parts of the mind and the identity. Because Jung says, until you make the unconscious conscious, it will direct your life and you will call it fate. This means dreams are not things to be interpreted or visions of the future. They are messages sent by your true self that only you can understand. Asking others for the interpretation of your dream is meaningless, as your dreams are told in a language that only you can decipher. He says, we can focus on repetitive symbols or patterns of events occurring in our dreams. He believes your inner self is trying to get the message ignored by your ego, because your subconscious has totally different needs than the needs shaped by the society. And it will try to tell you this somehow, till you get them and do whatever you need to do to satisfy it. Just a simple example. Think about a man with a really boring job. He believes he needs this job to survive, to stay alive. But he sees himself in a totally different situation. Places in his dreams every night, or similar patterns reoccur every night. This is a message for this person. The true self is not happy and trying to say, do something, change something, it will not turn out well. This person ignoring these messages just yells at the boss and slams the door and leaves. Out of nowhere, everybody says, why did he do that? More interestingly, he asks himself, why did I do that? The reason is the subconscious. This is a story where the subconscious gets what it wants. We see these everywhere in our lives. When we ask ourselves, why did I act like that? We have the answer, deep inside our subconscious. This is Jung's points of view on dreams. Personally, I'm on Jung's team. I thought, this is it, when I saw his description. That's what I believed. Our instincts, our subconscious guides us. Everything we do consciously has a different alternative or scenario in our subconscious. It works more than our conscious self in trying to turn us into our true selves. I always believed people needed to listen to their subconscious more. That we need to try harder to discover our inner thoughts, just as we discover the outside world. When we find it, the real us, that's when, I believe, we will find all the answers. So, It seems that the answer of the question, why do we dream, is another question. Who are you? And what do you really want? As always, until next time, bye!